Hello and welcome back to another AP podcast. Today, I am joined by Mack McLendon. He is the Jersey guy from the Chicago Bulls Orlando game, and he got poked fun of by Adam Amin and Stacey King on the live broadcast. What's going on, Mack?
How you doing, man? How you doing?
All right. So, first things I gotta say is, man, I gotta give you some respect for the way you handled that. You were getting roasted by everybody on like Bleacher Report, ESPN, all of that. How was that feeling?
Well, it's crazy because I think everybody thought that it was being shown on a Jumbotron, but it wasn't. Like, so during the game, while this was going on, I had no clue. So I didn't know what was going on until about the third quarter when I got a call from my cousin. Hey man, I think you're on TV. And I thought maybe that's a passing by during the game. And he's like, no, it's been about 10 minutes. So I really didn't know what was going on until then, but it's been crazy.
It looks like an old jersey.
I'm not gonna lie, that looks a little bit like the one that found on the street vendor, maybe.
Buy one, get two free.
You want this NyQuil Jordan jersey?
It's got ball. It's like the Bulls are like, it's like he might have made that at home. I'm just kidding, big fella.
Hey, where to rep the team, brother?
Where to rep the team, baby? Where to rep the Bulls?
Kobe White gives the Bulls their first lead of the night.
Oh man,
that's cold by us, man. They allow fans into the building, and we're just like, man, what's up with the jersey?
Oh man, come on, that was Adam Amin, my man. It wasn't me. Dude, I got nothing but love for you. Anytime you repping the Bulls, baby. Hey, I don't care.
It says Michael Jordan on the back instead of Jordan.
Yeah, and your initial reaction, did you just like, while you were sitting there, did you just kind of go on your phone and listen to Stacey just roast you? Like,
my girl did, because after a while we started getting text messages. My mom has called, you know. My job was calling, so I was like, what in the heck is going on? And then I finally hear it, and I mean, the only thing I could think, I was like, but you know, my jersey's real. it's a real authentic hardwood classic Jordan. Yeah,
where'd you get it?
It was funny though. What was that?
Where'd you get the jersey?
Man, I believe I bought the jersey in, I think it was 91, at a Champs sports store in Youngstown, Ohio.
So it's a legit, it's an oldie. It's not just one of those, hardwood classics, throwback ones. It was the real deal from back in 91.
It was actually the first jersey I had, just got my first job ever. It's the first jersey I ever bought. I only have two. I have that one, and I have a Brian Urlacher jersey for the Bears. It's the only two jerseys I ever bought, so that was my first one.
Yeah, well, talking about Brian Urlacher, so you're a Chicago fan. Did you grow up in Chicago?
No, I was born and raised in Youngstown, Ohio. I think it's just because I got into sports around the time when Michael Jordan started to blow up. And I just latched on to Chicago sports from since then. Cubs, Bears, Blackhawks, and Bulls, man.
Yeah, I'm kind of a wild card myself, but I'm a recent Bulls fan. I haven't always been a basketball fan, but yeah, I wasn't born in Chicago. So it's definitely cool to hear somebody else that, you know, wasn't a hometown guy, but still respect Chicago and the team. So another question I had was, I haven't really been able to talk to anybody about the COVID and the empty arenas. What was that situation like? Was it, how weird was it to be in an empty arena like that?
It's a little weird because I've been to games, you know, in the past, and you're used to the loudness of the crowd and everything like that. But I mean, I don't know how other arenas are doing it, but Orlando is really nice. You know, it's not a lot of people there, but they make it fun. It's interactive. It's a lot more interactive with the crowd, more than beforehand. But, you know, you get tested before you go in and you have to wear your mask. Your seats are all, you know, staged appropriately away from each other. So anybody that's worried about sitting right on somebody is not that at all. Yeah. So it's like, it's nice. It's nice. It's just different. It's just different, but more crowd interaction. So that's good.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely a weird thing. Can you hear the player chatter at all? Can you hear the bench or anything like that? Or
a little bit, but it's a lot more of, you can hear more of the crowd chants and, you know, it's more crowds yelling at the crowd on the other side. And the I think at this point, the way the crowds are, the mascots are important because their mascot was all over the place, man. And it was awesome. It was good.
Yeah. Sounds like a real interactive experience. So, a couple more questions. So I actually just want to talk about the Bulls for a second. Do you have any, you know, hot takes, opinions about any of the guys in the team?
I'm a huge Patrick Williams fan.
Yeah.
Huge. I know I was a little skeptical when we first drafted him because, you know, I didn't know that much about, I'm a North Carolina fan and he came from Florida State. So it's like, oh man, but the potential is there, man. He just has to work, you know, like everybody has to work on their game. We're young. I love the coaching. It just have to gel. People got to give it time. It's not going to change overnight, but I think we're in a good place. I think we're in the best place we've been maybe since like the Derrick Rose, Jimmy Butler era.
Yeah, well, Gar Pack's being gone. I'm just ready for some change. And this season's kind of an evaluation season. I'm not expecting to, you know, make the playoffs or anything. But, yeah, I love Patrick Williams. I'm a big Lowry guy. But at this point in time, I think I'm more attached to P. Will just because his defense. I mean, Lowry's defense is not good. But Patrick Williams has the potential to be like Kawhi. Like, he's got that ceiling.
So he can guard 1 through 5.
Yeah, so and when he's guarding LeBron, when he's guarding LeBron and LeBron's like, man, this kid, he's good. He's got big hands. He reminds me of Kawhi. Right. That's such good praise to hear. And I love to see a young Bull succeed like that.
See, with Zach LaVine and then you have Kobe White and him, if they can get clicking and on the same page, man, we got a nice little future ahead.
We do. I think we have one of the better future. I mean, people think about like the Pelicans with all those picks or the Thunder. I do want to see another guy next to Zach, like a Beal, somebody like that. I don't think we're going to do.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah, I know. Yes. I don't think we're going to do too much without, you know, another star.
One more proven star.
Yeah. What the direction we're headed in, man, I'm very excited. So.
And we really haven't seen a healthy Wendell Carter either.
Yeah.
If he can stay on the court and play with them guys, we can do some things
for sure. I just hope he can stay healthy. Him and Lowry already out, man.
Right.
Tough.
It's going to hurt.
Yeah. And then that Orlando game you were at, that was the one we lost, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah. So what was, give me your thoughts on that. What were you thinking when that game was going on?
It shows our lack of depth underneath because Vucevic just did whatever he wanted to basically.
Yeah.
He just, once he gets rolling for a big man, he can shoot the outside shot. He's an awesome passer. We just had no answer for him. But then they'd make that push at the end of the fourth quarter. It's like, where has this been? So, man. I mean, we're right there.
Right on the edge. Yeah. Zach, he had like 7, and then he went off for like 20, 29 or something. Right.
He had crazy. 6 at the half.
Yeah. Like he was 1 for 7, had like 6 points after some free throws. And he came alive. And then, yeah, we destroyed the Magic the game after. Like, absolutely killed them. And then, you know, tough loss to the Wizards. Tough loss. But overall, I'm really excited for the Bulls' future. And I know you are, too.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and anything you want to shout out? Any handles? YouTube?
Well, you can follow me on Twitter at McLendon Mack. I'm on Instagram as well at Little Mack World. Or if you're in the Orlando area and you're hungry, I work at Bonefish in Longwood, Florida.
Longwood, Florida, Bonefish.
Yes. The jersey is there and everything. Come by and say hi.
All right. Yeah. I'll make sure to tag everything in the description. But thank you so much, Mack.
No problem. Thank you, man. Thank you. And go Bulls.
Go Bulls for sure.